A Editora Globo apresenta Cursos de Idiomas Globo, Inglês. Fita 8, Lado A.
Lesson 57.
What about the circle?
It's 1 minute past two, it's 2 minutes past three, it's 3 minutes past four, it's 4 minutes past five, it's 5 past 6. It's 6 minutes past seven, it's 7 minutes past eight, it's 8 minutes past nine, it's 9 minutes past ten, it's 10 past 11.
Lição 57. Como escolher um lugar no teatro. Preste atenção. Lucy Lovett e seu amigo Adam Ross, que ela conheceu quando estava de férias nos Alpes, estão na bilheteria de um teatro escolhendo os lugares que preferem.
Have you got 2 seats for tonight's performance?
Yes. Where would you like to sit?
In the stalls, please.
I haven't got 2 together in the stalls. What about the circle?
Well, that's fine.
I've got 2 seats in row G in the middle.
Have you got any in the front?
Yes, there are 2 in row B, but they're at the side.
I'll take the ones in the middle. How much are they?
£10.50 each.
Here you are. So what time does it start?
7:30.
Thank you. It's 7:05, Lucy. Let's have a drink.
Okay. Repetition.
Agora apenas escute as frases e expressões.
Concert.
Opera.
Ballet.
Cinema.
Theater.
Have you got any tickets?
For tonight's performance.
For tomorrow's performance.
Performance.
Play.
Film.
Show.
There are 2 seats in row B.
In the circle.
In the stalls.
In the front.
At the back.
In the middle.
At the side. How much are they?
£10.50 each.
I'll take them.
What time does it start?
Start.
Finish.
Begin.
End.
It starts at 7:30.
It's 7:05.
Let's have a drink.
Nas pausas, repita o que escutar procurando imitar a pronúncia.
Concert.
Opera.
Ballet.
Cinema.
Theater.
Have you got any tickets?
For tonight's performance.
For tomorrow's performance.
Performance.
Play.
Film.
Show.
There are 2 seats in row B.
In the circle.
In the stalls.
In the front.
At the back.
In the middle.
At the side. How much are they?
£10.50 each.
I'll take them.
What time does it start?
Start.
Finish.
Begin.
End.
It starts at 7:30.
It's 7:05.
Let's have a drink.
Practice.
Exercise 1.
Tonight's performance.
O espetáculo desta noite. Neste exercício, você é o bilheteiro do teatro. Primeiro, um exemplo.
Have you got 6 seats for tonight's performance?
There are 6 seats in the stalls, in the front.
Which row are they in?
Row B.
seats 6 to 12.
Agora você é o bilheteiro.
Have you got 5 seats for tonight's performance?
There are 5 seats in the stalls, at the side.
Which row are they in?
Row G, seats 15 to 19. Excuse me, have you got 4 seats for tonight? There are 4 seats in the circle at the back.
Where are they?
Row F, seats 9 to 12.
Good evening. Have you got 3 seats for tonight's show?
There are 3 seats in the stalls, in the middle.
Which row are they in?
Row E, seats 8 to 10.
Could I have 2 seats for tonight's performance, please?
There are 2 seats in the circle, in the front.
Where are they?
Row A, seats 10 and 11.
Exercise 3.
Pronunciation.
Pronúncia. Preste atenção à pronúncia de L, E no final das palavras. Repita praticando o som O.
Apple.
Bottle.
Circle.
Comfortable. Double.
Impossible.
Incredible.
Middle. Single.
Table. Uncle.
Vegetable. Exercise 5. Now sing this song.
It's 1 minute past 2, it's 2 minutes past 3, it's 3 minutes past 4, it's 4 minutes past 5. It's 5 past 6. It's 6 minutes past 7. It's 7 minutes past 8. It's 8 minutes past 9. It's 9 minutes past 10. It's 10 past 11.
Acaba aqui a lição 57.
Lesson 58.
You should talk to him.
Sam should sell soap. He should, he ought to. I really think he'd like to. He ought to sell soap. Sam should sell soap. He should, he ought to. I really think he'd like to. Ought to sell soap. He ought to sell soap. He ought to sell soap.
Lição 58. Como aconselhar? Veremos também as formas verbais should e ought to. Presta atenção. Lucy Lovett e Adam Ross estão jantando num restaurante. Uma xícara de café caiu no vestido de Lucy e o garçom trouxe uma esponja úmida para limpá-lo.
Is everything okay?
Yes, thank you.
The manager would like to offer you both a liqueur. Will you have another cognac?
Oh, that's very kind of you.
Oh, thank you.
Oh, my hands smell of soap.
I can smell it from here. It's pretty cheap stuff, isn't it?
Do you know, there's a machine selling Dad's perfume in the ladies, but I didn't have any change.
Why doesn't your father sell soap? He ought to.
think he'd like to. You should talk to him about it, Adam. You're in the soap business. He's in the perfume business.
Between us, we could make your hands smell very nice. Repetition.
Escute e acostume os ouvidos aos sons dessas palavras e expressões.
This soap is pretty cheap.
It's pretty cheap stuff.
Why doesn't Sam sell soap?
He should sell soap.
He ought to sell soap.
He would like to sell soap.
He should.
He ought to.
He'd like to.
Adam is in the soap business.
Sam is in the perfume business.
Adam's soap is excellent.
Sam's perfume is excellent. They should become partners.
Agora que os sons já são familiares, repita nas pausas.
This soap is pretty cheap.
It's pretty cheap stuff.
Why doesn't Sam sell soap?
He should sell soap.
He ought to sell soap.
He would like to sell soap.
He should.
He ought to.
He'd like to.
Adam is in the soap business.
Sam is in the perfume business.
Adam's soap is excellent.
Sam's perfume is excellent. They should become partners.
Practice.
Exercise one.
My friend has hurt himself.
Exercício número um. Meu amigo se feriu. Participe desta conversa para praticar as diversas maneiras de se dar um conselho. A conversa começa assim.
My friend is hurt himself. He isn't well at all.
He should go to bed.
Ou então poderia dizer.
He ought to go to bed.
Agora vamos ver os seus conselhos.
He's broken his leg.
He should see a doctor.
Or
he ought to see a doctor.
The doctor is away.
He should go to the hospital.
Or
he ought to go to the hospital.
He hasn't got a car.
He should phone a friend.
Or
he ought to phone a friend.
He hasn't got a telephone.
He should catch a taxi.
Or
he ought to catch a taxi.
He hasn't got enough money.
He should catch a bus.
Or
he ought to catch a bus.
He can't. He's broken his leg.
Exercise three. Sing this song.
Sam should sell soap. He should. He ought to. I really think he'd like to. He ought to sell soap. Sam should sell soap. He should. He ought to. I really think he'd like to. He ought to sell soap.
E aqui termina a lição 58.
Lesson 59.
Could I have a ticket to London?
Could I have a ticket to London, please? Could I have a second class return? When does the train leave? When does it arrive? Or could I have a ticket to London, please?
Lição 59. Como comprar uma passagem de trem. Atenção. Diana Lovett resolveu que ela mesma tinha que fazer uma visita à pessoa encarregada de comprar perfumaria na Harrods, uma enorme e luxuosa loja de departamentos em Londres. Diana está na estação de Oxford comprando a passagem de trem.
Next, please.
Could I have a ticket to London, please?
First or second class?
First class, please.
Single or return?
Return. What time does the train leave?
11:35.
Is there a train from London to Oxford at about 6 o'clock?
I'm afraid I don't know. The information desk is over there. Next, please.
Is there a restaurant car on the 11:35 to London?
No, madam. But there's a buffet.
Next, please. Just one more thing. What time is there a train back from London to Oxford this evening?
6 minutes past every hour.
And how long does the journey take?
Exactly an hour. Next, please.
Repetition.
Ouça atentamente estas frases e expressões.
A ticket to London, please.
Single or return?
First class or second class?
A second class return to London.
What time does the train leave?
There's a train at 11:35.
There's another at 12 o'clock. I'll take the 11:35.
Is there a restaurant car?
Restaurant car.
Buffet.
Bar. Which platform?
Platform.
Ticket office.
Information desk.
Ask at the information desk.
How long does the journey take?
It takes an hour.
The train arrives at 12:35.
Agora que você já escutou uma vez, repita imitando a pronúncia.
A ticket to London, please.
Single or return?
First class or second class?
A second class return to London.
What time does the train leave?
There's a train at 11:35.
There's another at 12 o'clock. I'll take the 11:35.
Is there a restaurant car?
Restaurant car.
Buffet.
Bar. Which platform?
Platform.
Ticket office.
Information desk.
Ask at the information desk.
How long does the journey take?
It takes an hour.
The train arrives at 12:35.
Practice.
Exercise 1.
Tickets.
Exercício número 1. Passagens. Você vai fazer o papel de viajante nesta conversa. Primeiro, um exemplo.
Next, please.
A ticket to Oxford, please.
First or second class?
Second class.
Single or return?
Single, please.
Here you are.
How long does the journey take?
It takes an hour.
Thank you.
Agora é a sua vez. Faça de conta que é Miss Gillett.
Next, please. A ticket to Canterbury, please.
First or second class?
First class.
Single or return?
Return, please.
There you are.
How long does the journey take?
It takes an hour and 30 minutes.
Thank you.
Agora você é Mr. O'Neill.
Next, please.
A
ticket to Cardiff, please.
First or second class?
Second class.
Single or return?
Return, please.
Here you are.
How long does the journey take?
It takes 2 hours.
Thank you.
Vamos ver como é que você se sai como Mr. Peon.
Next, please.
A ticket to Edinburgh, please.
First or second class?
First class.
Single or return?
Single, please.
Here you are.
How long does the journey take?
It takes 4 hours.
Thank you. Exercise 3. Sing this song.
Could I have a ticket to London, please? Could I have a second class return? When does the train leave? When does it arrive? Could I have a ticket to London, please?
E termina aqui a lição 59.
Lesson 60.
The Progress Quiz.
This is the Progress Quiz for 41 to 60. 41 to 60. This is the Progress Quiz.
Lição 60. Esta lição é uma avaliação dos seus progressos até o momento. Servirá para você ver o que já sabe e repassar o que for necessário.
Exercise 3.
How do you say in English?
Verifique como se diz algumas expressões em inglês. Escute este exemplo. O que aconteceu? How do you say o que aconteceu in English?
What happened?
Agora a expressão com prazer. How do you say com prazer in English?
With pleasure.
E a questão B. Que azar. How do you say que azar in English?
Bad luck.
E a C. Fica ótimo. How do you say fica ótimo in English?
It's just right.
Agora a questão D. Tudo bem. How do you say tudo bem in English?
That's all right.
E, por último, a questão D. Uma passagem de ida e volta. How do you say uma passagem de ida e volta in English?
A return ticket. Exercise 7.
A camping holiday.
Um acampamento de férias. Escute o que esta moça está contando sobre seu acampamento de férias.
I took my raincoat in case it rained. It didn't rain, but it was cold. We had to camp because the hotels were very expensive. I like camping, but the cold was awful. I wore my raincoat and a scarf and gloves all the time. We made big fires to keep warm. One day, we didn't have any matches. I went to the shop to buy some matches, and I lost my money. Can you believe it?
Agora responda às perguntas que estão no fascículo.
Exercise
Exercise 11.
Interview.
Entrevista. Faça uma entrevista com a senhorita X e anote suas respostas. Escute o exemplo.
Do you speak English?
Yes, I was in England for 2 years.
Agora faça a pergunta A.
Did you like it?
Yes, very much.
E a pergunta B.
Were you in London?
No, London was too expensive.
E a pergunta C.
Where did you live?
In Oxford.
E a pergunta D.
Did you have a job?
No, I was at university.
E a pergunta E.
When did you come back?
3 years ago. Exercise 13.
Telefoning.
Telefonando. Escute a conversa telefônica com atenção e anote as frases na ordem certa.
Hello, can I speak to Maria?
Hold on. Hello?
Hello, Maria. This is Jane.
Who?
Jane! Is that Maria?
No. What number do you want?
476.
I'm afraid you've got the wrong number.
Oh.
Exercise 16.
Spelling.
Soletrando. Escreva corretamente estas palavras. Primeiro, um exemplo.
How do you spell phone?
P-H-O-N-E.
Agora você soletra e escreve.
How do you spell wrong? How do you spell honest? How do you spell station? How do you spell trousers? How do you spell sorry? How do you spell me?
E aqui termina a avaliação e a lição 60. Que pôs à prova os seus progressos durante o curso.
Aqui termina o lado A.